I generally locate the regulatory issues into two sort of broad categories. The one I call the conventional issues and the one more the industry-specific issues. And the general issues are the ones that would face any party investing in South Africa or in other countries. And those will be the corporate issues, how they set themselves up, what type of structure they use, do they need to register as an external company, those sorts of things. There'll be the tax issues, the employment law issues, the intellectual property, the consumer protection. Sometimes there'll be competition issues, sometimes there'll be environmental issues. And those are ones that we need to confront when we deal with parties coming into the country. But then what's more interesting and challenging in a way, and I'm a bit biased when I say this because this is my field, is then to look at the ad hoc regulatory issues that will confront an entity coming into the country. And whether we're talking about the accommodation sphere or the transportation or health and pharmaceutical or retail and packaging, there are very specific regulations that apply. And we have to do the digging and uncovering of those.
The landscape is moving at an extremely fast pace. We have so many new laws, so many new regulations. The way that business is being done today is very different to even 24 months ago in a whole array of different spheres, including insolvency law, new companies law, and there really is no shortcut to getting the right advice from the very start of a transaction. Even though Tanzania is a neighbour of Kenya and so close geographically, the environment there is very different. One needs to be even more cognizant of the fact that the regulatory and legal and social norms have been significantly impacted over the last couple of years. It is hardly ever the case that the transaction that someone comes to you with is completely new. There are always going to be some nuances and views and experiences that you can draw from other matters that you have dealt with in the same environment.
If you play it correctly, a regulator's bark would be worse than its bite. And if you treat the regulator with disrespect, you risk huge consequences. You're better off working together with the regulator, educating them and teaching them best practice from other countries on the continent.
It's much easier challenging regulations than it is challenging laws, because a law is a law, and really you can only challenge it if it infringes the Constitution. Whereas a regulation is an administrative act, and you can challenge it on your normal administrative law grounds, unreasonableness, irrationality, ultra vires the act, whatever the grounds are. So one of the things we would do with clients as well is look at where regulations can be challenged and should potentially be challenged in order to improve them. South Africa is generally regarded as the most tightly regulated country in Africa. And I think in an overall sense, and taking a big picture look at it, it's not a bad thing. Really what has happened since 1994 is that there have been genuine efforts by our government to bring us in line with other democracies in the world and introduce legislation like our competition legislation, our consumer protection legislation, our privacy legislation, our financial regulatory legislation, to bring us on a par with democracies in the world. But with that has come quite an intense and quite rigid regulatory environment that new entities need to confront. You want regulation to ensure that industries are properly regulated, but at the same time you don't want to discourage investment. And so it's always a difficult balancing act, and maybe we haven't always got it completely right, which is why I think a country like Mauritius is now seen as a more attractive investment destination than South Africa, because they've maybe been a little bit more alive to a more kind of favorable to investors regulatory environment.
Now, Africa has made significant strides towards reforms to make it easier for businesses to flourish in these territories. So there's been a lot of reforms around setting up portals to register businesses, for example. So a lot of efficiencies that have been created in terms of buying property and obtaining mortgages, and a lot of reforms to the insolvency laws, particularly in sub-Saharan Africa. At the same time, there's also been some problems that sub-Saharan Africa had to face around political instability and also policy makers vacillating. But overall, certainly Africa and sub-Saharan Africa in particular has made a number of strides towards making it a more investor-friendly environment. So my view is that provided there can be stability around policy making and transparency in policy making, which would then reflect in regulation, and of course also political stability, I think that Africa, given its size, has tremendous potential for growth.
What's an interesting trend that is developing in the continent is regionalization. So we are seeing countries, whether it's on the Lusophone side, whether it's the COMESA countries in Africa, you know, banding together, and you need to know when you need to engage with all of the countries, when it's possible to do a regional approach in particular jurisdictions. This is where our relationship with Linklaters is really important, because Linklaters can help our clients, and we work together in particular on Lusophone through their office in Portugal, through Lisbon, and then of course the Francophone side, where we have support out of the Paris office of Linklaters. Really important for clients to know that not only do you know the right people on the ground, but then you have the right expertise in a particular area, not only in the country itself.
I see like the East Africa community and COMESA even, but certainly East Africa community, SADC for example, all coming together as one block, having one uniform, for example, set of trade law and one uniform set of competition law that applies across the region. That's not to say we won't have national laws, but it'll be a bit like the EU, will become a massive trading bloc, and I see bilateral trade agreements between that bloc and other blocs around the world.